Krishna, the Supreme Personality of Godhead, Volume 1, Chapter 13, The Stealing of the Boys and Calves by Brahma. Lord Krishna brought his friends to the bank of Yamuna and addressed them as follows. Let us have our lunch in this spot. Let the calves remain near us, and let them drink water from the Yamuna. Sitting down on the ground and keeping Krishna in the center, they began to open their different boxes brought from home. Each boy began to manifest different kinds of relations with Krishna, and thus the scene was being observed by the demigods from heaven. The calves that were pasturing nearby entered into the deep forest and gradually went out of sight. When the boys saw that the calves were not nearby, they immediately cried out, Krishna! Krishna is the killer of fear personified. Everyone is afraid of fear personified, but fear personified is afraid of Krishna. By crying out the word Krishna, the boys at once transcended the fearful situation. Out of his great affection, Krishna said, My dear friends, you need not interrupt your lunch. I am going personally where the calves are. He searched in the mountain holes and in the forests, but nowhere could he find them. Brahma, who was surprised how a little boy like Krishna could act so wonderfully, he wanted to see more, and thus he stole all the calves and cowherd boys and took them to a different place. Krishna thought, Brahma has taken away all the boys and calves. How can I alone return to Vrindavan? The mothers will be aggrieved. He immediately expanded himself as the cowherd boys and calves, who were of all different features, facial and bodily construction. He also became the calves. And surrounded by such expansions of himself, Krishna entered the village of Vrindavan. The mothers of the boys came out of their homes and embraced them. Their affection for their offspring increased exactly as it did for Krishna. For 1 year continually, Krishna himself expanded as the calves and cowherd boys and was present in the pasturing ground. Brahma returned after a moment's interval. 1 moment of Brahma is equal to 1 year of our solar calculation. Brahma came back to see the fun caused by his stealing the boys and calves. Brahma began to think, All the boys, calves, and cows were taken away by me, and I know they are still sleeping. How is it that a similar batch of cows, boys, and calves are playing with Krishna? In order to convince Brahma that all those cows, calves, and boys were not the original ones, the cows, calves, and boys who were playing with Krishna transformed into Vishnu forms. Actually, the original ones were sleeping under the spell of Brahma's mystic power. But the present ones, seen by Brahma, were all immediate expansions of Krishna or Vishnu. All the Vishnu forms were of bluish color and dressed in yellow garments. All of them had four hands decorated with club, disc, lotus flower, and conch shell. All of them were looking transcendentally beautiful. Brahma saw that many other Brahmas and Shivas and demigods and even insignificant living entities, down to the ants and very small straws, movable and immovable living entities, were dancing surrounding Lord Vishnu. The forms which Krishna assumed were each and every one full Vishnu. When Brahma was thus standing baffled in his limited power and conscious of his limited activities, he could at least realize that he was also a creation of the material energy, just like a puppet, subordinate to the Supreme Personality of Godhead. Krishna took compassion upon Brahma's inability to see even how he was displaying the force of Vishnu in transforming himself into cows and cowherd boys. He appeared to be awakened from an almost dead state, and he began to open his eyes with great difficulty. He could appreciate the transcendental land of Vrindavan, where all the living entities are transcendental to ordinary nature. He could understand that, because of the presence of the Supreme Personality of Godhead in Vrindavan, that place is transcendental to all other places, and that there is no lust and greed there. Brahma thus found Sri Krishna, the Supreme Personality of Godhead, playing the part of a small cowherd boy. He saw that little child with a lump of food in his left hand, searching out his friends, cows and calves, just as he was actually doing 1 year before, after their disappearance. Immediately, Brahma fell down before the Lord, being very joyful, began to shed tears. Repeatedly, he fell and rose as he recalled the wonderful activities of the Lord. Seeing the Lord before him, he, trembling, began to offer prayers with great respect, humility, and attention.